Okay, the next medication you may be doing is called Delestrogen. It's also noted as E2V on your calendar. The medication is Estradiol Valerate. That's what the E2V stands for. But most of the pharmacies will send you the generic version, which is the Delestrogen. This medication will be given intramuscularly, and I will demonstrate where that will be given later in this presentation. You need to have a 1 ml syringe. You're going to use an 18-gauge, 1.5-inch needle, and then you're also going to need the 22-gauge, 1.5-inch needle to administer the medication. So the first thing you want to do is remove the medication from the box. Now, it will come with a metal cap on the top of it, and you will need to remove that metal cap. Then you're going to take and open up the 18-gauge, 1.5-inch needle and apply it to your 1 ml syringe. Now, as you can see, the 1 ml syringe does list the medications as being 0.1, 0.2, all the way up to 1.0. According to your calendar, you need to take 0.2 mLs. So you're going to pull it up until it comes to the 0.2. So you will remove the cap to the syringe, inject it into the vial of liquid, turn it upside down, and then pull back on the plunger of the syringe. And again, you want to fill up the medication about halfway. Then what you'll do is you want to flick it to get all the air bubbles out or to the top of the syringe, and then you're going to push back into the vial of medication. Until you get your mark, which is going to be on your calendar, is going to be 0.2. There may be instances where they have you do an increased dosage, so if it says 0.3, 0.4, just pull up the amount of medication that has been prescribed for you. You will then remove the syringe. You're going to remove the large needle. And now you want to open up the 22-gauge, 1.5-inch needle and apply it to the syringe. And now you're ready to give the injection intramuscularly. Okay, now you're ready to give the injection. Again, as I said before, this is an intramuscular injection, so we do recommend that you give it in the upper outer buttocks or your thigh area. If you're going to choose your upper buttocks, what you want to do is apply your hand at your waist, and you want to go about 2 inches below where your thumb sits. So you're going to go about 2 inches below, which is going to be right about this area. If you're going to use your thigh area, you actually want to look at your thigh, and you're going to go right around the middle of it. That's where the largest muscle is. So what you'll do is actually take the alcohol swab, clean the area of the skin, allow it to dry, then you're going to remove the cap from the needle, and you will actually inject the medication straight in. Now with the sub-Q injection, you typically will pinch up the area, but with the intramuscular injection, you want to actually spread the skin with your fingers. Then you'll inject it all the way in, and then push in the plunger to dispense the medication. Again, you'll pull it out, and then you're going to want to dispose of the used syringe into the actual sharps container. Now, for those women who are very small and need a smaller needle, we do recommend that you let us know that, because we can order you a shorter needle that is 1 inch versus 1.5 inch. Now, remember, it does need to get to the muscle, so it has to penetrate a lot of tissue to get that far. So only if you're very tiny would we recommend using the 1-inch syringe.